Hi everyone, I know I've been away from the channel for these past months, but as you just saw in the video title, it's because of this new course. It's finally ready, Creating Better Plans. Now we've got courses on post-production in Photoshop and axonometric diagrams, and then it seemed that plans was the topic to go now. This type of drawing is usually overlooked due to its simplicity, but creating an effective plan that delivers the essential information without making it too noisy and still manages to be unique and have identity can be quite a challenge. So if you're looking to improve your representation skills and want to learn how to take your plans to the next level, I recommend you taking a look at this course, because it's over the courses that I can really go in depth and explain every little step. And now that this course is finished, I'll be able to go back to the regular YouTube videos if you're missing them. Okay, so now instead of explaining everything about the course, I'm going to play the first short lesson, which is just 3 minutes long, and it's also the course trailer so that you can get the full picture. Also, the website is looking pretty fantastic and it contains all the essential info. Oh, and there's also bonuses for this first month of registration, but I'll talk more about that after the intro. So let's take a look. Welcome to the course Creating Better Plans. In this course, we're going to learn how to represent a plan from start to finish, together, step by step. Designing a project is usually very technical, as it's supposed to be, but sometimes we need to take that technical drawing and present it in different scenarios that may need to have a little bit more personality. Whether that may be for a competition board, for a university project, portfolio, or even for specific types of clients. Yes, the Canon Beam software that you use has the potential of achieving a good representation result. And for some occasions, that's more than enough. But it's important to know how to take it to the next level, to go that extra mile if there's the need. And Illustrator and Photoshop are the tools to do that. In these lessons, we're going to learn how to go from a basic PDF to a final result using different techniques. We're going to work with the vector shapes in Illustrator, learn some brother moves to manipulate the objects and organize the file to save time, and in Photoshop, test different effects, fills, shadows, textures, patterns, and a lot more. We're going to learn how to properly work with layers and build a strong file structure so that future changes are easily done. Essentially, we're going to use Illustrator and Photoshop linked so that we have the best of both programs. We're going to practice with this weekend contemporary country house. I'm not really sure what to call it, but this is a project that I designed specifically for this course. You're totally free to use one of your own projects, because that's the end goal here, right? You want to learn the moves and techniques in this course to apply to your own projects and plans. So feel free to adapt. In the resources that come with the course, you will get all the necessary files to follow along and practice at your own time and pace. And this is what's included: a CAD file, a raw 3D file, PDFs, JPEGs, Illustrator and Photoshop base files. The courses here at Upstairs aim to teach the programs and workflows by working on an actual drawing and image. I feel that it's much easier to learn by actually doing and practicing than just giving the theory about each tool. So in the next lesson, we're going to take a look at how this course is going to be structured, because understanding these major steps can help you streamline your process and learn where to begin working on a drawing like this. And don't forget that the discussion and comments section is available in each lesson down below to ask questions or share helpful information with other students. All right, I hope you're excited to begin this course, and I'll see you in the next lesson. All right, what did you think about it? I've been working on this course over the past 8 months or so, and I'm really excited to finally share that with you guys. Now, this is a course to learn the moves that take place after the plan is drafted, we're not going to talk about how to draw a plan in CAD or BIM, but more about how to improve it and present it in a unique way so that it enhances the proposed design. So as I said, for the first month of registration, there are some exclusive bonuses for those who enroll until the end of November. So it's going to be a mini plan pack, an extra exercise to practice the knowledge learned in the course in a fresh base, and then I'll be doing weekly live meetings in November to solve any questions and chat with you guys, which won't be available for those who enroll in the course after this period. Now look, the feedbacks over the previous courses have been incredible, and it motivated me to create this new one. And now I have put all my efforts into creating something special that will help you in your architecture journey. You can watch the first three lessons of the first module as a preview before deciding if you want to enroll in the course, so I'm gonna leave all the links in the video description for you to take a look at. Now, if you already purchased any of our courses or packs, you will get a launch discount code over your email as a thank you. Okay, now if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please leave them in the comments and I'll get to everyone. And again, I'm coming back with the YouTube tutorial, so if you do have anything in particular that you wanted to see, please let me know. Okay, thanks for watching until the end of this video. Don't forget to leave a like and I'll see you guys in the next one.